UPDF was yesterday on its second day of the recruitment exercise of the army. The targeted group of youth ranges between 18 and 22 who completed ordinary level of education. The recruitment was conducted at Kolo Independence Grounds with a focus on youth from Rubaga Division. Like the usual practice, they were engaged in a 3-kilometer marathon, which was followed by vigorous exercises and medical checkups, respectively. Major Charles Kabona, the spokesperson for the UPDF 1st Division, said they have been able to recruit 28 youth from Rubaga. He thanked parents for allowing their children to join the army. He emphasized the importance of recruiting healthy people into the army.
Ati nabazali tuwebaza nyu kubanga mtu wadabana. Na ye, nyaga kubagamba, program itandise jo, unaku ruwa mandi. Tujia kubanga tukumekereza, ina kuminanya. Tuina weeks.
One of the parents of the recruits, Akiding Ruth, appreciated the transparency exhibited through the recruitment exercise.
Right, but now people are shortlisted from the list. How can you start fluking?
In Kasese, however, several candidates failed to meet the minimum standards after some were found with body tattoos and others diagnosed with various ailments, including high blood pressure and ringworms. Pending roadworks on Jinja Road have prompted demonstrations leading to traffic jam yesterday. Residents and the business operators along this road say they are protesting due to the dust as a result of unfinished roadworks at the Nakawa to Nabisunsa section and the farmers market at Shireka. Traffic flow was disrupted when demonstrators lit fire in the middle of the road. Police put out the fire amid verbal exchange with the disgruntled protesters. The protesters want the Uganda National Roads Authority to act and complete this road. Alan Sempewa, the media relations manager at the Uganda National Roads Authority, assured the residents over the matter.
Tugenda kukola tubira okufuna yo kasente omwezi guno gwennyini ogutandise contract addemu okukola emirimu gy'omu kitundu ekyo.
Protesters clashed with police in Kenya's capital Nairobi yesterday, and some were arrested after peaceful anti-government rallies descended into scattered incidents of violence and looting. Activists have stepped up their campaign against President William Ruto, despite his decision last week to withdraw a controversial finance bill that triggered what he has branded treasonous protests by young Gen Z Kenyans. The Kenya National Commission on Human Rights said that 39 people had been killed and 361 injured during 2 weeks of demonstrations. They condemned the use of force against protesters and labeled it excessive and disproportionate. They condemned the use of force against protesters and labeled it excessive and disproportionate. Largely peaceful rallies against a raft of tax increases, mostly led by young Kenyans on social media, descended into deadly chaos on Tuesday last week when lawmakers passed the deeply unpopular legislation. After the announcement of the vote, crowds ransacked the partly ablaze parliament complex in central Nairobi as police fired live bullets at protesters.
Ruto Magro!